how many weeks or months na nakita mo na may parang may improvement na sa band ninyo?
Okay. So actually dito sa camp, just like what I've experienced, the dog would most likely stay here for a month or so, or most likely a month. Pag after nun, before going 3 weeks, you can already see the results na yung aso mo parang connected na kayo, isang command, yung mga ganun na mga bagay. You can establish the bond before the training can be finished.
Before anything else, umpisa ng training yung bond talaga, yung
yes,
yung very important.
Yes, because actually the bond with the dog is the most important connection with the human. Kasi pag wala yung bond, like for example, like a stray dog, you're a stranger for a stray dog, the dog will not listen to you or will not acknowledge as a part of his pack, because you know, you are not imprinted in the mind of the dog. Hindi ka associated sa kanya, hindi kanya kilala. So why would it go to you?
Hmm. Kay Sir Giro naman, Sir Giro, maganda yung sinabi ni Sir Paul sa experience niya na lumapit siya sa inyo. Train your dog,
yes.
Or ano yung mga requirements for para maging trainable yung,
yes,
aso. So para sa inyo, sa own experience niyo, anong best age na magsimula ng training, behavioral training?
In our practice here sa camp, ideally we start at 3 months old.
Okay.
Once the vaccination is complete, we can start the training.
Mm.
And we have also an experience here, like they say, it's hard to train an old dog a new trick. But for example, Blake is a 10-year-old Bichon mix. Will be na-train din namin si Blake for obedience. A 10-year-old dog.
10 years old.
But it depends on how the dog respond. But sometimes, age doesn't matter. So in the camp, we accept like 3 years, 4 years of age. It depends how the dog responds.
Mm.
For example, I told you, si Blake.
Si Blake.
Yeah.
Pero sa owners naman, pwede ba nila matrain yung dogs nila sa household nila? As early as 2 months or
as soon as the dog dumating sa household mo, mm, like 8 weeks old,
okay,
you can start an early socialization.
Basta nawin na
siya. So of course we don't recommend to walk your dog because di pa sa complete siya. So
what household lang.
Yeah, like Conan, what I do is like sa harapan ng place namin, I let him observe people passing by, different stimulus, auditory stimulus, different sound of tricycles, jeepneys, and objects.
Mm.
So that it will be easy for me to train my dog pagdating 3 months old.
Kumbaga may parang may priming ka.
May priming.
Oo.
Foundation.
Uh-oh.
Kasi sa age ng 3 months, that's where the character of the dog starts to develop.
Okay.
So very receptive for training yung mga puppy. So that's why it's a good advantage for the owner na yung aso nila pag start ng puppy, you start training your dog and start socializing with different stimulus.
Ayun, tama yung mga sinasabi ni Sir Giro, no, na very important talaga yung priming. Huwag natin na kasi marami akong nakikita,
yes,
na agad-agad tinuturuan ng kung ano-ano.
Mm.
Oo. So, mahalaga yung sinasabi ni Sir Giro na priming muna. Build up the stimulus,
yes,
of the dog.
Yes.
Before anything else.
Yes.
Diba? Very important talaga yun, yung sinasabi ni Sir Giro na build up yung stimulus, tapos yung parang may primer before the training talaga will start. Ayun. So, gusto rin natin malaman kung ano nga ba yung advantages ng isang aso na nag-underwent ng training whereas sa aso na hindi nagkaroon ng training at all. So baka may ma-share kayo sa amin, sa mga viewers natin.
Yeah. The advantage of a well-trained dog is you have a controllable and predictable dog. Most dogs, if hindi is untrained siya, they're going to pull you the leash, jump on you, chase animals. But if the dog is trained in obedience, you'll be able to control those instincts, those instincts of a dog, like prey drive, because dogs in nature are predator, so they'll be able to control those instincts. And Paul, we'll see. Okay.
So I just would like to add, no, na dogs are naturally learning. Yes. Whether you train them or not, they are learning. They are learning your behaviors. They are learning kung ano yung gumagana, ano yung hindi gumagana.
Yes.
So whether you train them or not, they are learning. But it is you, it is the person, it is the owner, the handler, the trainer that creates the boundaries, that creates the limitations to have a dog that can fit in a household.
Yes.
That is the one of the advantages of training a dog properly.
Okay, so that's it for today's episode ng Training 101. So abangan nyo ulit yung next episode together pa rin with Sir Giro and Sir Paul. So ako po si Doc Harold Ray Dimaisip, ang brand manager ng Pet Options. See you sa susunod na episode.